G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with the Coleman Big Game C-6 sleeping bag. Hit it. This is a big, roomy bag with a durable canvas outer, a soft flannelette liner, perfect for winter camping. So when you get your Coleman Big Game sleeping bag, this is how it looks when it's packed up. It weighs about 4.4 kilos thereabouts and measures about 50 centimeters in length and about 30, 32 centimeters in diameter here. That's as it comes from the factory. This is rolled up from the factory in here. We'll show you how to pack it up a little bit later, but there is this compression sack here to try and squash it down. And when you've got it set up, this is how it looks. It's a hoodless design. It's about, well, Coleman say 213 centimeters in length. I get that if I really stretch it out, it's probably about 200 by about 90 in width, or just over 90 in width, whereas Coleman do say 101, but you can stretch it out that far if you like. Now, Coleman have used a 10-ounce poly cotton canvas on the outside of the bag here. Doesn't have a really stiff feel like canvas that, say, tents and swags are made of. It's got a reasonably flexible, soft feel in terms of canvas, but it gives it a nice, durable outer. And on the inside, quite the opposite, a nice, soft flannelette lining, and sandwiched in between the inner and the outer is Coleman's Coltherm synthetic insulation. And if I sort of lightly puff on that, it's probably 5 or 6 centimeters in thickness there, and that's all the way around. It does have a little pocket here to keep your phone or keys at hand at night. And it also comes with a pillow. So I've got this pillow here. Look, not much of a pillow. There's a bit of fill inside there. It's going to give you a bit of padding. But if you like a lot of support or you've got broad shoulders, you're probably going to need more than that. But hey, that is included. Altogether, all of this fill gives, well, Coleman say it's a -6 degree bag, but at Snowy's we say probably more like around about zero. It hasn't actually been tested to a standard, it's a little bit of a guess, but all the feedback we've had is comfort down to about 0 degrees. General construction of the bag is rectangular, so it's the same width all the way to the foot, and it doesn't have a hood on the top here, but it does have this nice big soft, what they call their comfort cuff. So the bit that's up against your skin isn't the canvas. It's the soft flannelette on the top here. The rest of the bag is sewn. It doesn't have what's called a sewn through construction. So there is this stitching here to kind of hold the insulation together inside, but that doesn't match up on the outside. So this canvas is almost like a bag on the outside of the bag to give it protection. So it's certainly an efficient design. Going to give you lots, you know, tons of warmth with this sort of design rather than being a sewn through sort of construction. And it is machine washable. So if you've got a machine big enough, you can throw it in the machine or hand wash it if you like, or you might need to take it to the laundromat. Now there's one continuous zipper that runs down the side and the foot of the bag here, and it has Coleman's zip plow feature on it. So this little plastic cap on the top here sort of separates the fabric to stop it from jamming as you zip this up and down. So, and that works pretty well. This zips all the way down the side, and it's the same zipper that is for the foot section here. So you don't have a separate zipper for the foot, but you do have this zipper at this end here, and you can unzip it that way if you like. So if you just want to unzip the foot section, let a bit of air in at the foot end, you can do that. To zip two bags together, you unzip this all the way to here and separate it, and then lie this down, and the second bag then zips on top of this bag like this. Your best bet if you're joining two together to make a double is to join two big game sleeping bags together. You can zip other Coleman bags to this. I tried it with the Pilbara, but the zips are slightly different lengths and it doesn't really work perfectly. But these bags are probably perfect for zipping two styles together because of this straight top on here. You don't have a hood section. If it was a hooded bag with this design or this sort of design of bags where one sits on top of the other, one person always ends up with a hood in their face. So quite conducive to making a nice warm double bag out of this one. Now I'm going to crawl inside this and try and describe the room or space that I've got inside. Now I'm 185 centimeters in height. So this being about 200 centimeters to this point here makes it suitable for people over 200 centimeters in height. So it's going to suit most people's height. And if I lie down, try to get my head on the mat with my head just above the next section there so I could have a pillow, pull this over the top, I feel quite comfortable. My feet are sort of this far from the end of the bag, so I could actually crawl right down in the bag and put my pillow in the bag if I liked and lie down on that. My feet still feel comfortable at the end there. It's not a box foot design on here. The zipper does come to kind of a a point like this. It's not built out, but I still feel like I've got tons of room in there for my feet. And with regards to width of the bag, if I just lay down again, I can get my arms sort of right out like this, and I've got heaps and heaps of space in here. So certainly feels cozy. I feel warm lying in here right now, and I feel like I've got heaps and heaps of material up on top of me here to keep me warm at night. So I'd certainly feel comfortable sleeping in this down to at least 0 degrees, I reckon. Now, in terms of packing it up, it is a bulky bag. Coleman have what they call their wrap and roll feature, which is these little red tabs on the side. Now I'm gonna show you how this works, and then I'm going to show you an easy way to roll it up. So the first thing we do is fold it in half. And if we do that, we can see this tab and this tab line up. So we want to put this tab, or the little plastic tab, through the loop on the opposite side. We do that halfway down the bag. It's only halfway down at the foot section. There isn't one at the top. So do it at this end as well. And these tabs correlate with the red strings that we can see hanging down at the foot end of the bag here. So this is all part of the wrap and roll feature. We've got a loop on one side and a string of the hook on the other. So we want to start to roll from the head end of the bag. So we come up here and begin to roll as tight as you can, because it is going to be firm to fit back in the bag. Remember from the factory, there's some machine that probably did this and got it rolled up really tightly. Now, what these did is just stop the bag from splaying as you roll it. It keeps it nice and neat and square as you go. Then these straps here are kind of in place of a separate strap, I suppose, just to kind of hold it in place to get it in the bag. Now you can see even that, I haven't rolled that up tight enough to even get them to meet there. So I don't want to push that too, or pull that too hard, because they're only just stitched it on the end here. I'm probably going to pop that out of its little stitching point there. So an easy way to pack it up is to do away with the wrap and roll feature. It's a good idea. It's great on probably the lighter weight bags, but these heavier weight bags, we're just going to use the stuff method, and probably for all sleeping bags really, I'd say stuffing is better, because it's probably better for the insulation on the inside to be stuffed in its storage bag a little bit in a sort of irregular sort of manner. So to get started, put the zipper, the foot end, into the bag and push the zipper right down to the bottom and kind of lift this up as you go. So you've got it up above the bag. And then you just kind of want to spin and stuff, and then lift, spin, and stuff. Now, this outer fabric does make this a stiff bag to work with. Eventually, you get to a point where most of the bag is stuffed in its storage bag. So you just keep working around, keep spinning it, filling all the gaps that are inside the storage bag. Keep spinning around, punching it down. Make sure you punch it right down at the bottom. Don't wait till you get to the very end to try and squeeze it in. Put your fist on top. So that's right inside the bag there now. Pull it closed. And then you've got these compression straps. And these compression straps actually work better when the sleeping bag's stuffed in an irregular shape, because you don't have kind of sheets of synthetic laid flat in there. They're irregular inside. You can push this down on top and squash it all up. So that is how I recommend you pack up not just the Coleman Big Game C-6, but any sleeping bag. I forgot the pillow, but that'll squeeze inside there as well. That's the Coleman Big Game C-6 sleeping bag. A really durable option for campers, maybe hunters. It's got a very subdued color to it, so it's not going to stand out. Certainly going to keep you warm for winter camping. Check them out online at snowys.com.au, where you find them at our lowest prices every day. Got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of the latest and greatest information, or check out some other cool Coleman sleeping bags like these ones down here.